Today's video is to give you a very brief introduction about the contending theories that are relevant in the discipline of international relations, or in short, IR. For this reason, I have consciously opted out idealism and post-colonialism. I, Dr. Debashish Mitra, welcome you all to my channel, Basics of Political Science. What are the major relevant theories that are in IR? We will briefly discuss about the study of international relations, which takes a wide range of theoretical approaches. Some emerge from within the discipline itself. Others have been imported in whole or in part from disciplines such as economics or sociology. Likewise, many theories of international relations are internally and externally contested, and few scholars believe only in one or another. Hence, there are different categories and ways to explain IR. Each developed a broad framework of analysis. Thus, there are liberalism and its different strands, like neoliberalism. Realism and its different strands, like neo-realism or structural realism, and post-structuralism, constructivism and post-constructivism, Marxism, feminism and its different strands, critical theory, and green politics. Liberals' focus of analysis was: all states have essentially the same goals and behaviors, at least internationally, like a self-interested actors pursuing wealth or survival. Major actors are individuals and private groups, not states, are the fundamental actors in world politics. For instance, majorly the non-state actors, NGOs and all those. States represent some dominant subset of domestic society whose interests they serve, and the configuration of these preferences across the international system determines state behavior. Key concepts in regarding to strength and weaknesses: many critics argue that too much emphasis on rational behavior, which is bereft of power, and consequently which is the core of world politics and human behavior. For realists, sometimes termed structural realists or neo-realists, the international system is defined by anarchy, the absence of a central authority. State power is the major actor, indeed the only variable of interest, because only through power can states defend themselves and hope to survive. Realists hold states to be rational actors. This means that given the goal of survival, states will act as best as they can in order to maximize their likelihood of continuing to exist. Realists assume that all states possess some military capacity, and no state knows what its neighbors intend to do. Thus, the key concept is real politics, that is, power politics. It is the oldest and most frequently adopted theory of international relations. But realists' overriding emphasis on anarchy and power leads them to a dim view of international law and international institutions, ideas, and others. Constructivism owes much to intellectual developments in sociology, particularly sociological institutionalism. Constructivism is characterized by an emphasis on the importance of normative as well as material structures, on the role of identity in shaping political action, and on the mutually constitutive relationship between agents and structures. Major actors are state and their ideas constructed through events or experience. Constructivism has also emphasized as one of the key concepts the role of non-state actors more than any other approaches. Constructivists argue that material resources only acquire meaning for human action through the structure of shared knowledge in which they are embedded. For example, Canada and Cuba both exist alongside the United States. Yet, the simple balance of military power cannot explain the fact that the former is a close, that is, Canada is a close American ally, and the latter, that is, the Cuba, is a sworn enemy. Constructivists contend that agents and structures are mutually constituted. It notes that international bureaucracies may seek to pursue their own interests, for example, free trade or human rights protection, even against the wishes of the states that created them. Critical theory. In essence, critical theories is a bunch of theories, it can be said, who have challenged the dominant international relations theories and their underlying positivist epistemology, that is, those theories which are seeking reasons from a range of perspectives. Scholars working in Marxist, feminist, post-colonial and ecological fields have all put forward critiques of international relations, that is, the explanations of state behavior. For example, Marxist scholars perceive the emphasis on state-to-state relations as obscuring the more fundamental dynamics of global class relations. Similarly, feminists have sought to explain aspects of state behavior and its effect by emphasizing gender as a variable of interest. This focus has led, for example, to notions of security that move beyond state security, which is, of course, of paramount importance to realists. We have to understand that also. State security is of paramount importance to realists. Thus, what I want to mean is that critical theorists has moved beyond the state security to notions of human security. In such a perspective, the effects of war, for example, it reach far beyond the battlefield to family life and other aspects of social relations. Green politics is perhaps the newest. Many of the writings of green thinkers and the practices of green movements contain both analysis of the dynamics of global politics and normative visions concerning the restructuring of world politics. Within this green theorists, some scholars believe, or they suggest, that the defining characteristics is ecocentrism. That is, what do you mean by ecocentrism? That is, the rejection of an anthropocentric worldview. Anthropocentric means everything around the nature is centered around human beings. So this anthropocentric worldview should be rejected which places moral value only on humans in favor of one, which places independent value, that means that green theorists places independent value on ecosystem, that means also on ecosystem and all living beings. Apart from the rejection of this kind of anthropocentrism, Dobson suggests that a second key feature of green politics is the, I quote, limits to growth. This is an argument about the nature of the environmental crisis. Greens suggest that it is the exponential economic growth experienced during the last two centuries which is at the root cause of the current environmental crisis. We will continue to add more videos on each and respective theories. Till then, goodbye. And if you do like the video, please subscribe and press the bell icon for further videos. Thank you.